Thank you very much, Alderman. I would begin my time by thanking not only Jeffersonville High School, Big Club, Bill, teaching such students in such an excellent way. I want to thank all of you for coming out here, whether you're Democrats, Republicans, Independents, Klingons, Jedi. This is an important election. Let me give you some quick biographical background on myself. I'm 50 years old. I have lived in my congressional district pretty much my entire life, minus the time that I have served in the United States military. I have a beautiful wife going on 25 years this year. I have four children. Two of them are here. They'll be voting with them for the first time. I'm a lifelong Democrat. I've been in Clark County pretty much my whole life. Some of you know me pretty well. I'm not a politician. I'm a statesman. This is a vocation. The country needs someone to step forward and represent you. Todd Young, the Republican establishment, stole your voice and your vote and held it in check for 6 years. I was the only Democrat who was willing to step forward before Todd Young got his race and say no more. It's got to be done. The Democrat must step up and get rid of this crony. Now, once Todd left, lots of people showed up because it's easier. I have the belief that the people in Indiana would respond to my message all across my congressional district. I'm going to make two promises to you. I'm not a big fan of politicians making outrageous promises. I'm going to make two outrageous promises to you. I mean it with all my heart. As a United States military veteran, both the Air Force and the United States Navy, I took an oath to preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic. My first duty as your congressman is to this document. My second duty is to you. If you never ask me to do anything that's unconstitutional, you will have the finest congressman in the state of Indiana has ever seen. I will work for you and you alone. Not endorsed, I'm a citizen like yourself. I have received no money from outside this district, and every donation I've received has come from a voter inside the district, $20 or less. I will belong to you, I am Washington. I will be your public servant. My second outrageous statement is that once I get to Washington, I'm going to listen to you. And here's how I mean I'm going to listen to you. In Washington, you call your congressman's office, do you get to speak to him? No, you don't. You can speak to a staff. I have pledged publicly at every public appearance I will spend as many hours as is reasonably possible answering my own phone in Washington. This is how I will stay grounded and stay a statesman, your politician. I'm hearing your voice. I'll hear your concerns. You'll hear the sincerity of my voice as I answer your questions. You won't just be some name and a check mark on a spreadsheet that some staffer hands me. This will help me keep grounded. I won't turn into one of these career politicians like Todd turned on us and like countless others have turned on us at the state, the local, and the federal level. I thank you very much for coming out. I need your support and your vote. Again, I am just one man, private citizen, who has stood up to do a service for you because I have served you before as a United States military veteran. I need your vote, your voice, to spread this message to other people. Thank you very much for your time.
I would like to thank each of the candidates for attending, and I would also like to thank all of the audience members.